Welcome to Electroline. Now let's ask the question, how do we know that stars are still being born? Are we able to take pictures of that right now? And the answer is, nowadays, because of our modern telescopes and the Hubble Space Telescope, we have been able to zoom in to some of these locations in some of the nebulas where we can actually see star formation in process. So we know, in fact, that they are still being born. Stars are still forming out of nebulas, just like we explained in the previous video. But before we had those pictures, how did we know? Because we already knew before that. And one of the ways in which we knew was by looking at some of these galaxies. So here is a picture of one of my favorite galaxies, this NGC 1300. It doesn't have a name, it's just known by its NGC number. And notice that it's a barred spiral galaxy. It's barred because the central bulge of the galaxy tends to be rectangular in shape, and it only has two spiral arms, one come off each of the end of the rectangle. But if you take a look at these spiral arms more carefully, and I hope you can see it through the camera there, that there's a lot of blue light in the spiral arms. Where does that blue light come from? Well, it comes from blue giants. What are blue giants? Well, let's go back to the HR diagram. Notice the blue giants were the stars on the main sequence that were in the upper left corner. They're massive in size. They have a mass anywhere from 5 to 15 times the mass of the Sun, where a typical star is even less than the size of the Sun, about 40% of the mass of the Sun. So these are absolutely massive stars that put up an enormous amount of light. But one of the things about blue giants is that they only last about 10 to 50 million years on the main sequence. They are so enormously large that the nuclear fusion process just burns up all the hydrogen inside the core, turns into helium, and then those stars turn into red giants. So they're only there for 10 to 50 million years, which means they cannot be very old. So when we see blue giants, and you can see there must be lots of them because there's a lot of blue light coming from these blue giants, even though we know that one blue giant could outshine as many as 1,000 or 10,000 regular type stars, there's still a lot of blue light there telling us that those stars just recently formed within the last so many millions of years. And so if that's the case, we know that if those stars are forming, probably many of the other stars are forming as well, and therefore it's still an ongoing process. So we knew all along by noticing those blue giant colors in the spiral arms of many galaxies around the universe, that star formation is still something that's actively happening. Now, we do know that blue giants are relatively rare stars. Compared to typical stars, they're in a ratio of about 1 in 1,000 to 1 in 10,000. So for every one blue giant that is formed, 1,000 to 10,000 regular stars are formed. So the fact that there's so many blue giants means there's many more regular stars that must be formed in those spiral arms as well. An ongoing process, and so let's take a closer look and see what that is all about. So come back on the next video and we'll show you more of the process of starbirth. Okay. All right. Yes, you're a good doggy. You're a good puppy.